Hello. In this video, we'll look at installing the popular Elasticsearch project on Google Kubernetes Engine. Elastic has recently shifted from using a Helm-based approach to an operator-based approach, so we'll follow that best practice for installation. Chances are, if you're watching this video, you're already familiar with the champion of distributed search and analytics engines, Elasticsearch. In case you haven't, it's a great Apache Lucene-based project and boasts over 60,000 stars on GitHub. Let's quickly dive into how we can install this on GKE. First, we need to create a Kubernetes Engine cluster to run our Elasticsearch instance. We have two options before us, using a standard Kubernetes Engine cluster, which involves managing node pools and other low-level details, or taking the higher abstraction route with Kubernetes Autopilot, a service that abstracts away node pool management. We'll opt for the latter, choosing the sleek and simple Autopilot service for our GKE cluster. With the API enabled, we'll create our Autopilot cluster and give it a name. The default settings should suffice, but customization is available if you need it. Though we're using an Autopilot cluster, note that the installation approach is virtually identical for standard Kubernetes clusters. The only difference is specifying node pool configurations like CPU and RAM. With the Kubernetes cluster ready, we'll spin up Cloud Shell for CLI-based installation of Elasticsearch. Feel free to use your preferred IDE, just ensure your gCloud CLI is authenticated with Google Cloud. Configuration can be done with gCloud init or by activating a service account. As for installing Elasticsearch, we have a new way of doing things. Instead of the now obsolete Helm chart, we'll be following the recommended operator-based approach in a different Elasticsearch repository. We'll proceed by installing both CRDs and the operator right from the command line, assuming our kubectl CLI is configured for this cluster. While Autopilot has some opinions, controls, and limitations, CRDs and operators can be installed without a problem. Let's get the operator up and running, visible in the Elastic System namespace. This operator will manage any Elasticsearch instances we provisioned with a custom CRD. Next, we'll need an editor for the Elasticsearch instance resource, and we'll follow the installation instructions closely for installing that resource. Apply the Elasticsearch CRD here in the default namespace, and soon you'll see the system coming to life. Voila! Our Elasticsearch instance is running, complete with a stateful set, persistent volume claims, and services on the standard 9200 port. We hope that this quick walkthrough has been helpful, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Please enjoy responsibly.